So my name is James Odongo. I'm the Chief Administrative Officer at the Kenya Extended Producer Responsibility Organization. This is a producer responsibility organization that came into being following the Kenya Plastic Action and the ban of the plastic, single-use plastic, back in 2016. So we've been in operation since March 2021. And within that space, we've had quite some good milestones. We've managed to recycle over 7,500 tons of flexible plastic and managed to pay a total of up to 70 million on subsidies to the different recyclers we've contracted. Of course, based on the reach we have, we are currently present in 31 counties. And of course, as we wait for the gazettement of the regulations, the EPR regulations, we expect to expand our reach to really accelerate Kenya's realization of a circular economy through promotion of a recycling ecosystem and incentivizing separation of waste at source and sustainable waste management practices. So our membership is really broad, and we allow for membership from across the different actors throughout the waste value chain. We have members, currently we have a total of around 450 members, spanning across the brand owners, packaging users, waste recyclers, waste pickers, as well as other interested parties within the members of the public. Within the space of the Fair Recycling Project, this is a build-up to a conversation we've had with the Danish Refugee Council for quite a while now. And so KEPRO committed itself to the project as a technical resource entity, and more particularly towards ensuring a just transition as far as incorporation of informal waste pickers and waste collectors within the respective refugee camps. And of course, within that space, we are also offering technical support in terms of creation of awareness on separation of waste at source and sustainable waste management practices. We're also looking at providing a lot of technical input on how to incentivize and ensure waste management is done in a sustainable manner within areas of operation for DRC. Sadly, the Kenyan ecosystem as far as waste management is concerned is largely informal, and the operations of waste recyclers and waste management in the country heavily relies on the said informal waste pickers and collectors. And so understanding that, we are working a lot with the Kenya Association of Waste Recyclers to not only sensitize the waste pickers on how best to formalize their businesses, but also rolling out technical input and resources for the waste pickers to understand and integrate them into the formal recycling ecosystem. Further, we are also going into the space of operating material recovery facilities, which would ensure a just transition for the waste pickers, so that while we are formalizing and greening our planet, we are also creating formal and really relevant employment opportunities for the different waste pickers to ensure that theirs is a dignified opportunity for employment as opposed to continuously operating as an informal ecosystem. So we understand the pivotal role of women in the waste ecosystem and the larger recycling ecosystem. If you go to most dump sites and material recovery facilities, the bulk of the workers are usually women. And so what we've noticed and what we are really trying to do is do a lot of research and fact-finding on issues around gender within the waste ecosystem. And so within that space, our board and our other partners are in conversations to see how to roll out a gender mainstreaming program to ensure that waste pickers are not treated in a manner that is dehumanizing as far as gender is concerned. And even in terms of support for operations, we give a lot more prominence to community-based organizations that are women-led. So we offer support in terms of PPEs and financial support as far as capacity building to be able to make a business case for their operations. For Fair Recycling, we see it as an opportunity to essentially accelerate and, of course, giving credence to DRC, really playing a part in accelerating the conversation for Kenya moving from a linear economy to a recycling economy and further down to a circular economy. And so such programs and really feeds into KEPRO's strategic mandate and core values on commitment and collaboration between the different actors. And so for us, the Fair Recycling is really a unique opportunity and an exciting one because it is an uncharted space, and looking at how refugee camps and really the vulnerable populations within our societies are able to benefit from waste, because essentially for us, waste is wealth.
Fair Recycling Project. Reduce, reuse, and recycle with dignity.